he promised me a trip out, and we're down here at Penn Elcom, down in Hastings. I haven't seen the seaside yet, but I know they're partnering with Osram and have done since 2005. So what are we going to see today?
Well, Gary, we're hopefully going to take our LED tape skills to another level. Now, we've featured a lot of LED strip on the channel before. We've soldered, we've cut, we've showed you some of the extrusions available, but today we're going to see how the pros do it. And that's not us. That's the guys behind us here in this workshop. So they assemble complete projects for Osram to a tight specification so that when it turns up on site, it's install ready. Now in this video, you'll see some absolutely fantastic tips, and we've got some things in this workshop that are top tips. But at the end, you'll have two choices. So everything you can see in this video, you can order from Penn Elcom, or you can hand it over to the guys in this workshop and they'll do all of the assembly, cut to length, pre-wired, ready for you to fit. So I think that's some great choices.
Well, it seems like it's more like your world than my world. So I think you're going this way and I'm going that way.
So we're here with the star of the show, and this is Leon. Leon, so how much lead tape have you soldered over the years, do you think?
Miles.
Miles?
Miles and miles, yeah.
Yeah. In how many lengths? Lots of lengths?
Lots of lengths.
Tens of thousands?
Short one, yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah,
now, you've developed behind us what we call the third hand. It's a special little jig, isn't it? Robust. So, well, let's see how you use the third hand to put the wires on some lead tape.
Okay.
Yep, so what we're doing first, we're just going to tin the pads up, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So we've got some Osram LED strip. Okay, that's good. Now, I'm normally chasing it around the bench at this stage.
I mean, yes.
We have tried the solder, mate,
yep.
Which is good. But with this, you're kind of closer to the action, aren't you?
So. Yeah, nice and steel for you as well, so.
Yeah. Okay, so next stage.
Nice bit of weight at the bottom. Take our wires,
yep.
Our cable, whatever you prefer to call it.
Yeah, so you're going to tin them up now as well.
We're going to tin the ends, yeah.
Okay, again, that was nice and simple. And just give them a little trim now. Wow, that is pretty close coupled there.
Just keep the soldering iron nice and clean.
Right, yep. Just use Gary's wig. Alright, so here's the critical bit. Now I've never seen this done before. We're hovering above the bench. And then just going in for the negative connection. I mean, wow, that is a neat joint. I mean, when I do it, normally you burn back the insulation along the conductors, but that is one neat way of doing that. So we've got some tools here on the bench.
Yep.
So what we're using for stripping the...
We've got some General 69s here.
General 69s.
Yep.
Okay, so how many... And use those just for trimming the ends of the wires? Or do you...
They can be used for many different things. So okay. Yeah, like, they can be used for splitting.
And then we'll bring in, we call these the Richard Brooks after our electrician's challenge. But I guess next question we get asked is a cable. So let's go and have a look at different cable options. So Leon, you've brought me over to this fine selection of cables you've got here. Is this the standard cable you use on most projects?
Yes, yeah, pretty much industry standard, all of it. So
we've just done a single colour one. So yep. I guess this is the cable here, is it? So this, what do you call this?
This is a two core.
Yeah.
We call it a shotgun cable.
Right. Why is that? Because it's got two barrels.
Yeah, that's the one, yeah. It's used in the audio industry, but...
Yeah, right. In the audio, there's an inside of shotgun cable. We'll like that. Even on the multi-strand, we've got some more strands here.
No, these are more like a type of ribbon cable.
Yeah, that's what I'd
notice. We've got
notice,
three, four and five... a tunable, so your two coloured types of LED. Your two
So tunable
colored.
White on there.
Yep, that's your colour temperatures.
Yep.
We've got your RGBs.
Yep.
And we've got your RGBWs, which is your white as well on your RGBs.
Right. Now, I've noticed the subtle difference between these cables here, that the actual, there's a difference in order between this one's RGB and this one's GR.
That one there is pretty much an industry standard version.
Right.
But this has been, I believe, made for a customer.
So right, okay.
So where they've made their own LED.
Right.
And you've adapted that. It's been made for by somebody.
Yeah, and they've adapted that to that. And we've even got a clear cable.
Yeah, sometimes when you're hanging lights and you're using wires.
Right.
Rather than having that hanging from the ceilings, if you want to hide that up the wires, then yeah.
Yeah, okay. It's, so you've showed us putting them on the LED tape.
Yeah.
What sort of typical length are you putting on for a project?
All different lengths. Pre-prep, half a metres, 1 metres, twos and threes,
yeah.
Which is the most common, but can be anything.
Right.
Obviously longer lengths, changing thickness of grades.
Okay.
For resistance.
Right, so what, depend on the power of the tape, is it?
More like the long runs, get resistance down the cable, trying to push the power down the cable. Yeah.
Okay, so we've got that, and then we've got some rubberized cable here as well.
We tend to use this, the IP rated stuff.
Okay.
Waterproof, splash proof sort of thing, different IP rates.
But surely on a big project, you're not going to cut all this by hand?
No, we use the cable machine here.
All right, well, let's...
For our bulk runs, yeah.
Yeah, so this looks like the eFIXX viewers sometimes complain about the price of cable strippers. This looks like an expensive piece of kit.
It's a very expensive piece of kit.
Right, Leon, you've brought me over to what you're reliably telling me. This is the Schulinger.
Yeah,
it's like a Swiss watch.
Swiss-made machine, yeah, very clever.
Very clever. So what we've got on the screen here?
Obviously, the programs, different settings
for
different types of cable. It's all set up for a two-core at the moment, which is all set up through the machine.
Okay, so what can we set on here? I can see the length. We've got some at 10 metres on there.
Well, pretty much everything. You can give it a part code. Type in the description, the length, obviously, the quantities you want to do. It'll do a countdown for you. You can do it in batches, different batch sizes, production runs.
All right, okay, well, push the button. Let's see it go. Oh, it's the mouse set it going.
It's a mouse, yes.
Wow.
So it will cut and strip, then it will stop and it will strip the other end. And then it will drop them out, half a metre lengths today.
Wow, let's have a look at one of them.
No need for a bucket.
So that's spitting them out. All right, yeah, so it leaves that, does it always leave this little slug on the end?
Yes, well, you've got a choice. You can have it taken off, you can leave it on there. You can set the different, quantity or the size, the different lengths you want strips. You can have one end or no ends or, you'd set the machine to do whatever you want it to do, basically.
Oh, wow, I mean, that's a clever bit of kit. Does it, can it just do two core?
It does two core, you can change all the blades. You can do three core, you can do all the ribbon cables, five core.
Wow, that's a good bit of kit. Well, not quite one for the toolbox, but if you're doing a lot of LED projects, this is what you need. So we've left the workshop to come round to this part of the warehouse here, Leon. So what have we got here?
This is where we store all the LED extrusions.
Now this is a pretty big range. I mean, this is, there's a lot here.
Yes.
And I mean, now I'm amazed how many different types of profiles there are for LED tape. We're here, obviously, do you cut them here to the exact size?
Yeah, we use the saw that's over there to the side. We get jobs picking tickets and the guys pick it, cut on the saw.
Okay, so that's a special saw that's just for cutting LED profiles and extrusion.
We use it just for cutting aluminium and LED profiles and extrusion, yes.
Right, so when you're cutting them, you don't cut one at a time either, do you?
No, definitely not. We cut multiples.
Yeah, all in one go.
All in one go.
All perfectly clean and neat.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow, so I guess, that's good. That's a good technique. Difficult probably to replicate on site. So let's have a look now when we bring the LED tape back together and for that final assembly. So before we go and see that final assembly process, let's just have a little look in this warehouse here. So there's a massive quantity of LED strip, LED tape, call it whatever you want, and all the components to go with it, drivers, power supplies, cables, the accessories for the extrusions. Now, we've learned a top tip while we've been here, and everyone knows on eFIXX we love a top tip, and we also love a part number. Now, I expected to see all the LED strips and tape in one area, but actually they're spread out all over those warehouse. That's to help with the picking process, so you don't necessarily mix up part numbers. It's very easy, if you're picking something, to be able to tell the difference between one part number and another part number. But that's important when it comes to LED strip, because if you've done a big LED project, you'll know colour consistency is important, and LEDs are produced in batches. Now, if you get those batch numbers wrong, it's a bit like buying wallpaper and paint, that the finished result may not be the same. Remember, on a paint can it says always, if you're going to buy another tin, buy right the same batch code. It's the same with LED lights. Now, the great thing about Penn Elcom is by the time this LEDs gets through to that final assembly process, it's been selected to be consistent colour temperature, colour binning, you may hear the words. So when it ends up on site, everything looks fantastic. So Leon, we're at the final stage of the assembly process. We've got our cut tape, we've got our wires on, we've cut the extrusion profile. We're now just going to stick it together. So let's have a look at the top tips you've got for us here.
Okay.
So Leon, what we're going to do first with the extrusion?
Right, we're going to prime it first.
Okay, so, I've never primed an extrusion before putting the LED tape in.
No, it's just basically a cleaning process, and also it takes any excess off the back of the extrusion that helps the LED stick a bit better.
Okay.
Stops it lifting in the future.
So that's a 3M primer matched to the, obviously there's 3M tape on the back of the Osram tape. So I guess the boffins at 3M have worked carefully to make sure this is perfectly matched.
Yep.
So you're just getting, getting a rag.
You can use a little brush.
Yeah.
I find that using a rag, you don't use as much up. And also the brushes, the actual bristles on them tend to go sticky and hard.
Okay.
So you need a lot of brushes.
Okay, so just give that a quick once over. Yeah, I guess you need a long bench for this part of the process.
Yeah.
Depending on what's the longest piece of extrusion you tend to do with standard?
We do 3 meters.
Right, okay. Yeah. Okay, so you need a good 3 meter bench.
Yeah.
Right, so we're now going to put the tape in.
Yep. So we peel the back off. I tend to do a little bit at a time.
Okay. Do you get any sort of second chances with it?
Or is it not really. It's your best to get it in place. First time, because trying to pull it back out, you can end up damaging the LED. Especially with the primer as well, because the primer does really help it stick.
Yeah, I can imagine so. It's a bit like putting a window on a double glaze frame. Once the tape's gone, it's going in.
This one's a bit more tricky because the extrusion's a bit deeper.
You just do a little bit at the end, and then just carefully work your way along.
Yeah, careful. Be careful with your fingers, because you can damage the LED in the chips, obviously from static. I mean, very rare, but it does happen. So the less you touch it, the better.
Yeah. Okay.
Let me go, and it's in.
Well, in this case, just that final clip the top on and put our end caps in for our finished extrusion.
I've got an end cap here with a hole in the end.
Yep, okay, just slot that end cap in, and then does it just clip the diffuser into place? Quick test, off all works.
So Gordon, what have you been up to?
I've learned some absolutely top tips during this visit, Gary. The way the projects are assembled, confidence in the product that's been delivered. Now that's that choice you now have. If you're an electrician and you're taking on a big project, you're not confident in your soldering, you don't know how to cut profiles properly, you're doing that on a building site upside down with brick dust all around you, I'd seriously be considering just handing the project over to the guys here.
Well, I heard a rumour you've got a third arm now then, Gordon.
Oh yeah, I mean that's my takeaway tip on how to solder LED tape is using the third arm. Now drop a comment below what you thought of that. Would you like to buy one if that was a product that was available? But what have you been up to, Gary?
Well, you're talking about products and products that are available. Penn Elcom also make racks and 19-inch racks. And I've been the other side of these doors exploring the process from raw material to end product on those. And you'll be able to check that video out. And I'm sure it's in high above our head. Link in the description below, in order that you can see that video. But for this one, we're interested in your feedback. Do you believe that you'll use Penn Elcom for your projects? Is it something you didn't know that was available and now you do and you're considering using it? Do you think you'll use their website in order to source your materials for your own projects? We'd be interested in all of those comments. If you can leave them below, we'll try and get back to as many as we can.